I ain't never been arrested or nothing. This is my first time going to jail, Mr. Stallone.
And he think my name is Stallone.
Yeah.
It's not Mr. Stallone. All right, we out.
You take care of your wife. She told me she's pregnant. Is that right? So you know what that means? That means be cool and stop getting into trouble. You hear me? All right?
I said, look, you know, you got a young wife. She's pregnant. I said, why don't you get out of selling drugs and just, you know, get into something legitimate and get straight.
Come about. I'm watching TV one day. I'm flipping the channels. I'm like, Steven Seagal, Lawman. And it's like, I'm really a cop. And this is like the intro, you know, the intro that you say at the beginning of the show. And you're in the car working the beat and doing the whole thing.
I had gone to Louisiana about 25 years ago on some music stuff. I'm a musician, as you know.
Yes.
And there's a sheriff down there, named Harry, since passed away, but I didn't for a long time. He was a very famous kind of a guy, and he had wanted to meet me. He had heard that I have great shooting skills, and so somehow we got together, and I demonstrated my skills, and I heard you guys are not allowed to show guns during daytime TV. I wonder if I'm allowed to talk about it.
Yeah, you can talk about
it. Okay. So I showed my shooting skills and my martial arts skills to, you know, several different SWAT teams, and they were duly impressed, and, you know, at that point, Harry asked me if I would come on to the force, and I started, I just said, what do you want? And he said, well, you know, I'd like you to patrol with my guys and get the bad guys and help the good guys. And we kind of started out like that.
So were you doing this all along? Like, while you were doing
for the last 20 years, I've been a police officer down there. Yes.
Well, it's remarkable that you know, we're not aware of it, but you were working. So now you do this reality show. Do the cameras affect it at all? I mean, are they with you all the
time? It's hard, you know.
Yeah.
Life goes on and policies change, and you know, you always have to be up on the new law. And you got the cameras there, of course, everybody's a little more nervous. But, you know, we got a great department and a great new sheriff, Noel Norman, and a lot of really brave young men and women are doing a great job in Jefferson.
Yeah, but what do people say when they see you? They're waiting for somebody to yell cut?
We do high-risk warrants, you know, yeah, where we'll have a six-man team dressed in black with machine guns, and, you know, we'll kick in a door and jump in there and get everybody safe. And when that kind of thing happens, nobody knows who I am, because oftentimes it's in the dark. And a lot of our patrolling is in the dark, and a lot of the bad guys we hit them fast. Sometimes, you know, and you'll see it, you know, on the show, folks will recognize me. And if it's, you know, kind of a simple stop that we're not too concerned about, we'll humor them.
Mm-hmm.
And if it's not something that we think is, you know, easy or humorous, we don't let them talk. I don't even let them look at me. I say, you know, get on the car and look at the car.
Mm-hmm.
Because we have to keep everybody safe, you know?
Yeah, and you probably take a lot of that experience into the films that you make. Now, you've got The Keeper. This is a new film. And we're gonna show a clip of it. Tell us, it's a little vigilantism, or is that, am I off?
Gosh, I mean, I didn't really look at it that way. I'm a police officer, and I get kind of betrayed and shot by a fellow police officer in a drug deal, and I have to go out IOD and retire.
And what's IOD?
IOD means injured on duty.
Oh.
And I retire, and then one of my friends calls me up and asks me to bodyguard his daughter, and so I go in as just sort of a bodyguard. And during the course of investigating why she needs to be bodyguarded, I understand that there's a lot of corruption that is even involved in the police department, so I can't really, you know, do things the normal way. It's not really vigilante, but I just have to do things a little bit more surreptitiously.
Right. Okay, here is Steven Seagal in The Keeper.
If I sign those papers tomorrow night, everything I have worked for will be torn away. And I don't give a damn. I just want Nikita back. But I don't have a choice.
Let me tell you something, you do have a choice, and you're not gonna sign those papers. Where's the drop?
Up in the hills? He's built a new hacienda. I know it well. I have the plans.
I'm gonna get your daughter back. You don't worry about nothing. I'll give you my word. You hear?
Just like that.
What about your... So you're doing all this. You're doing the reality series where you're an actual police officer. You have this movie out, The Keeper, and you're a blues musician. A couple of CDs here. When do you have time to do music? And how did that all start? What's the deal there? Did you ever kill a guy with a guitar?
Nah, but I did strangle somebody with the strings once.
Hello!
Nah, you know, I mean, music is, it's something that, you know, people who really love to play music, it's something you wake up in the morning, first thing you do is go get your guitar. You go to bed at night, you can't go to bed without, you know, saying goodnight to your guitar, you know what I mean? So we all love, we just love to play, and I've been playing since I was a baby. And I love the blues.
Steven brought a copy of The Keeper for everyone in the audience. So that's... And of course, you can see Mr. Seagal, Steven Seagal, LawMan.
And Fox.
Fox took care of it for us. Yeah, yes, that's
I'd like to thank Fox for that, too.
Yeah, that's nice. So you can watch Steven Seagal, LawMan, every Wednesday night. I mean, he will be right back.